Now, I have given you a definition for the multiplication of a matrix by a scalar. Now we are having properties. Okay, we are having properties. Properties of multiplication of a matrix by a scalar. Now, what type of properties we can use for solving the question? Now, number one, we are having K A plus B is equal to K A plus K B, and number two, we are having K plus L into A is equal to K A plus L A. Okay, so these basic, they are very simple thing. Okay, indeed it is a simple thing, but how we can proceed for the definition part. Now, if A and B are two matrices, we are having, if A and B are two matrices of same order, we can write M cross N, okay, of same order, then this and this is justified or not? Let's check it. Okay, so proof number one. Now, K A plus B should be equal to K A plus K B, and remember this K is a small K, it is not a capital K. Okay, this is a small K. Now, how to proceed, how we can show this one is, so let's proceed, start with the left hand side. For the left hand side, now we are having K A plus B. Now, what A and B can be, we can write it here. A is equal to Aij for order M cross N, and B is equal to Bij for order M cross N. Okay, two matrices, one denoted by capital A and one denoted by capital B, and this is the any of the order, and Aij are the number of the elements. When we are putting the values for I and J, we are getting the desired order, desired matrix of the desired order. Okay, so now K A plus B can be written as K, to this A we can write it A I J plus B I J. Okay, now further this can be written as K A I J plus B I J. Now this is by definition of addition of matrix. Okay, we have done already this one. So K A I J plus B I J, when it is combined, it is by the definition of addition of matrix. Now further this can be written as, now K A I J plus K B I J. Now what this becomes, how it is possible, just now we have done it by definition of scalar multiplication. By definition of scalar multiplication, so K multiplied by Aij and by Bij. Okay, now this becomes K Aij 1 plus K Bij. Okay, so order will be same order, M cross N. Now this is K Aij plus K Bij, and this is equal to, now what it becomes, now this becomes K A plus K B. Okay, and this is proved, we are getting K A plus K B. Okay, so this first part is proved. Now for the second part, is k plus l, where k and l can be numbers. Again, one can be real, one can be imaginary, both can be real, okay, both can be imaginary. So now for the second property, we are having that if we are multiplying two numbers with a given matrix, sorry, we are adding the two numbers and then multiplying, the result will be same if we are getting separate by multiplying the numbers. Okay, now we are having property number 2 is k plus l is equal to ka plus kl. Now sorry, ka plus l. Again, once again, if we are having two scalar numbers, we have to add the numbers, and if it is one is real, one is imaginary, we can't add it. Okay, so then multiply k with a and then l with a. Okay, the result of this part and the result of this part will always be same. This we have to prove it. Okay, so now again, starting from left hand side and using the same things. Okay, here we are using only a matrix A only, that is for Aij. Okay, now we are having k plus l a. Now to this, what we can write it? We can write it k plus l Aij. Okay, Aij is of order m cross n. Now this becomes k Aij plus l k aij plus l aij. Okay, now this is by the definition of scalar multiple, by definition of scalar multiplication. Okay, now to this we can write k aij plus L A I J, and further it can be written as K A I J plus L A I J, and this becomes K A plus L A. Okay, so again we have proved that K plus L times A is equal to K A plus L A. Okay, so whenever we are getting the questions, we will be getting the right answers. We can easily prove left hand side is equal to right hand side. Okay, so this is proved. Now easily we can move for the questions part for this question. Now for example, we are having two matrices A and B of the same order. The matrices are, we can take any of the example. Suppose we are having A is equal to 1, 2 and 4, 5. 1, 2 with rows, 4, 5 with the second row. A is equal to 1, 2, 4, 5 and B is equal to 3, 6, 0, 1. What we have to find now? We show that we are having 3a plus b is equal to 3a plus 3b. Now this is the property, this was the property which we have discussed right now. Now adding the two matrices then multiplying by a scalar, is it equal to individually multiplied the matrices A and B by the scalar number, and then will the result be same? Let's check it. Now left hand side, we are having 3 and we are going to add two matrices 1, 2, 4, 5 plus, remember I told you we can use matrices with this round bracket also, okay, with 3, 6, 0, 1. Now what the result is? we are having 1 plus 3, that is 4, 2 plus 6, 8, 4 plus 0, 4, 5 plus 1, 5. Further, multiplied by 3, we are getting 12, 3, 4, 12, 3, 8, 24, 3, 4, 12, and 3 into 5, 15. Okay, so we are getting left hand side in this manner. Let's check it about the right hand side. For right hand side, first of all, A multiplied by a scalar number 3, okay. 3A is equal to 3 times 1, 2, 4, 5, and this becomes 3, 6, 12 and 15. 3, 6, 12 and 15. B, now 3B. 3B is equal to 3 times 3, 6, 0, 1. Now this becomes 9, 18, 0 and 3. Okay, 9, 18, 0 and 3. Now let's check it. What we are having? Again, once again, let me tell you, 3A plus B, when added A and B, 1 plus 3, 4, 2 plus 6, 8, 4 plus 0, 4, 5 plus 1,